In their interface with officials from the judiciary, MPs on the Public Accounts Committee were concerned about the skyrocketing stock of domestic arrears in the judiciary. The Auditor General's report of financial year 2022-2023 indicated that management illegally accrued domestic arrears to the tune of 6.29 billion shillings in the year under review. As of 30th June 2023, the total arrears were amounting to 10.299 billion shillings accrued from rent, utilities, goods and services, land, property plant and equipment plus motor vehicle repairs. This irked members of parliament and they faulted the judiciary for stifling the private sector which supplies the government on credit.
Zero accumulation of domestic arrears. Mr. Accounting Officer, the Auditor General notes, I note that management irregularly accrued domestic arrears to the tune of Uganda shilling 6.2 billion in the financial year 22-23. The domestic arrears accrued included rent, repairs of motor vehicles, and supply of judicial attire. The details are in here in the table. Accounting Officer, you need to respond to this, but for me, I'm very interested in the issue of rent.
Here, when Chairman Chivumbi called us for discussion of these, the way you're going to conduct business, I told him that there are some things that are beyond our control, especially when the utilities, things to do with the rent, where we've got contractual obligation, and then we ask finance to give us money, we don't get the money. That's where the problem comes from.
Permanent Secretary Pius Bigirimana had none to blame but the Ministry of Finance that has not been providing funds to the judiciary to settle debts with its suppliers, according to him.
And they have refused to give us. They have not provided for it. So we shall continue. Let me tell you, we shall continue domestic arrears until Jesus comes back. If we don't give us money to pay, we shall continue, because I'm not going to tell courts to get out. Finance has to give us money and we pay.
But committee members reminded Bigirimana that by taking more credits when the entity is wallowing in debts of previous financial years, it is not only irregular but a violation of Section 21, Clause 2 of the Public Finance Management Act.
Saying that he is going to continue incurring arrears
till when Jesus comes back.
And there is a law here. And Mr. P.S., you know.
We shall pay.
Mr. P.S., you know, your functions are being governed under Section 45 of PFM. You are judicial people. And you know the sanctions thereafter, you know.
Bigirimana defended his actions and said that the judiciary lies on rentable premises in order to operate courts. He noted that he cannot close courts of law because of arrears and vowed to continue violating the law even if it fetches him jail sanctions.
If I have to be sanctioned because of not getting International Crimes Division out or anti-corruption court out, let me be indicted. If that is what you are talking about, I can't remove them from there. You only tell finance to give me money and I pay.
But committee members faulted accounting officers on failing to prioritize domestic arrears in their budgets, which ends up straining relations with creditors who rely on timely payments to meet financial obligations.
Why don't you plan these arrears in your entity before you tell us you will sink to prison? Isn't it a failure? And you senior PSS should help the country that this can be addressed. What figure are we talking about? 10 trillion.
Across
10 trillion across government agencies.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.